All right, so if you are in the cannabis industry, you cannot go anywhere without running into Jason from Dope Magazine. It's true. You kind of are everywhere.
That's true.
Yeah, so Jason obviously works for Dope Magazine. Out and about, you have a pretty great grasp on what's going on in California within the industry. So maybe you can just take a second and tell our community what is Dope Magazine, and then we'll just have a conversation.
Okay, well, Dope Magazine stands for Defending Our Plants Everywhere. Mm-hmm. And that's what we do. We defend the plant where it's legal, recreationally, where it's legal medically. And my job is to find the people that are the trusted brands in the business, the best of brands in California and all over the country, and get them inside the pages for my readers so that when they're going through that, they understand that these are the top people in our industry. These are the best things that you can purchase. Our quality is always top shelf, top level. And that's what I do. I just go around and I meet great people and put all the good guys in the book.
That's great. And so there's a big sea change going on in California right now. And so I'd like to ask you two questions. The first one is, what is your view on what's going to happen post Prop 64, assuming legalization happens? And two, what is your just sense of the changing landscape?
It's real interesting. I think all the polls are saying Prop 64 should pass. And what that's going to do is kind of thrust the whole industry into the spotlight. So you have a lot of businesses that are prepping for that. You know, they work with me, they're getting their marketing in line, they're getting their brands in line. And I think that's really the most fundamental change, is that even 5 years ago, if you went to a collective, you would buy things that were strain specific. You would buy an OG Kush or a Jack Herrera or a Blue Dream. Now people are asking for people by cultivator, by extractor, and that's the big fundamental difference. Is people go, oh, I want to buy the Guild, or I want to buy Gold Drop, or you know,
because people want to have trust in
right. They want to have trusted brands, and that's where it plays into Dope. Where since we work with trusted brands, you can go in and say, oh, I saw an ad for Gold Drop. Yeah. I know that their cartridges are good.
Yeah.
I always say that I look at us like the GQ of cannabis, and you would never see an ad for Target in GQ magazine, even though they're a $1 billion company.
Yeah.
You won't see subpar brands in our magazine, and I think that with Prop 64, a lot of those subpar brands are going to go away, because the people that are compliant, the people that are doing this the right way, the people that understand business are the ones that are going to kind of float to the surface.
Yeah, and so subpar, I would just emphasize, subpar might be brands that aren't giving accurate dosing, brands that use chemicals that are harmful to
weird solvents, you know, things like that. People that are trying to cut corners as opposed to put out the best quality product that they can.
That's great. Well, I like the sort of worldview you're giving me, and I'm just going to go with it.
Go with it.
Thank you so much for coming
by. You're welcome.